live from Studio One, Jan Ølholm and Felix Jacobsen.
Yes.
Hello and welcome to Widex Matchrace Academy. This is the first show and we hope we are able to make even more every week here during the corona. So it's a good chance for us to learn a little bit and discuss our favorite sport, match racing. And I am Jan Ølholm, and in the studio today we also have
Felix Jacobsen, and thank you for letting me be here today, Jan.
Yeah, and the same. Yeah, but I have been sailing a match race for about 5 years. The last 2 years as helmsman, and Felix is our coach. So so he's kind of the expert. Yeah. And also the technical person here in this show. So what are your expectations, Felix?
Yeah, I'm looking forward for this show here. I've been working on it for almost the whole week. You know, all the audios and the filming, camera stuff. But I can introduce myself a little.
Mm-hmm.
My name is Felix, and I've been sailing match racing for almost 10 years now. My top position in the world ranking was 32, I think, 32. Being a part of some big match racing regattas around the world. I think the last one was Sopot match racing in Poland. It was a great one. And now I want to coaching some new match racing guys like Widex, to show them it's not only serious to say match racing, you can also have fun. The fun way of match racing is the way in the future if you want to build up a good match racing team.
Yeah, and today we have, if you have questions, you can, if you are logged into YouTube, you can put it in the comments, and if not, you can find me on Messenger and write me, because then a little later in the show here we will I will look and see, you know, if you have if there are any questions, and then we'll put that in. But we have also got two international people helping us with the show, and that is, you'll see that a little later. But actually, the whole purpose of today is talking about how to become a better match race team, and with focus on team. That is basically, I mean, match race is so much a team effort, because everyone needs to have their right place, and everyone need to contribute, and that's really important. So let's and actually we have got. Some input from Brazil and from UK, and from Brazil it is Bernardo Lobier, who has been sailing a lot of match racing, and he's sailing in Berlin today, and the other one is Miles from UK, also a very experienced sailor, and they have come with their views on how they see the how to create a good match race team. So let's start to look at, see what they are saying.
Yep.
Let's do that.
Hi Jan, so here we go. First question was, what makes a good match race sailing team? And in my opinion, one of the drivers for a good matching team is to have consistency. A good example I have in there is Patrick Zebroja from Poland, and I saw how he improved his way to being in the top, I think, 10 of the road ranking, just through consistency, and he just hanged in there many years, and ended up beating the best sailors in the road. Of course, a portion of talent is also not bad to have, and have the right people on the right jobs, but the biggest part is just to hang in there, train together, have a consistent crew, and So that's it.
Hi, I'm Miles from the UK. So the first question, what makes a good match racing team? I think there are two super important things when thinking about a match racing team. The first one, you have to enjoy the company of the people you sail with. So you obviously spend a lot of time with the team that you sail with. And it's very important that you guys get on and you have a good time when you go away and go to these events. And the second thing, I think you need to trust everyone that you sail with, because in match racing, everything happens quite quickly. So if you can rely on your team and trust them to do the things you want them to do without having to tell them, then that puts you at a massive advantage.
Yeah, and that was kind of the first question we asked them, and as we could hear, there was something about consistency, just keep on doing it, and also something about have fun while you're doing it, because at the end, along the way, you will learn much more about it. And how do you see that, Felix?
Yeah, you know, I think the first thing, if you are totally new in match racing, you need a team to sail with. I think it's very important to make a agreement for the whole team. Everyone on board want to do the same as yourself. Mm. So you know, if you want to do it 100%, you want to sail this 6 regattas per year.
Yeah.
You want to be the best match racing team in the world. Then you have to agree with the whole crew. You know, they all want to do the same as yourself. So when you all have the same goal in the team, I think it's a good match. Yeah. For the team.
Yeah, and especially sometimes maybe you can have maybe the helmsman or some of the crew, you know, they want to be number one and the other ones wants to drink beer and sail once a month. Then you kind of have a little bit of a problem on a team. So, but let's see, we have asked them another question. So let's hear what they say.
All right, second question. What make a good team spirit? In my opinion, this is being able to have always a constructive learning curve, is to be able to lose one or several match races or even championships and not get a bad mood, but willing to get better only after each race, and then come to the next race again with heads up to do the best each time. And of course, people are not always on the same level and have different availabilities and points and times in their life to make the team. So it's always important to consider this, that you might be doing your best, but you need to set the right expectations also.
Okay, so the second question, what fosters a good team spirit? I think the most important thing about fostering your team spirit is that you don't take yourself or the sailing you're doing too seriously. You're super lucky when you go match racing that you're always in a new place and you get to meet lots of new people. And I think the most important thing is that you enjoy that as opposed to worrying too much about the result. If you enjoy the sailing and you enjoy meeting new people and being in a new place, then the results tend to follow.
Yeah, and so that was a little bit more about, you know, the team spirit. And as Miles said here, you know, you really make sure you enjoy it, because and also something about, you know, that the ones that you're sailing with, you know, it's very good if they kind of become you know, friends and good comrades, because it also makes it much more fun to sail. And what is your take on this, Philip?
Yeah, I think that the same what I'm telling you before. You know, if you have the same goal as, you know, everyone on board, you're making by yourself a good team spirit on board. I think a good team spirit on board is also you're not, when you are pushing each other out to the limit, you're not consist to tell them they are bad. You have to make a gain, telling them it's a good job you're doing what you're doing right now, and not tell them they are a big idiot all the time. Of course, you have if they are a big idiots, you have to tell them as a team boss on board, and the team boss is everyone on board. But this guy that's sitting on the ranking in the end, it's actually your driver. I think it's important to everyone have a chance on board to tell what they want to say on board. They have to. Everyone on board are part of to make a good team spirit.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. And that's really important. And also, of course, you know, having a good tone on board. But that we'll come back to that a little bit. But it's not all easy about it. So actually, we also asked Bernardo and Miles about what are actually the challenges, because it's not always easy to make it work as a match race team. So let's hear what they say.
And the last question is, what are the challenges to make a good and stable team? And for this, I'm suspect to say, because I have a bit of trouble, especially to get a stable team. I have the main challenges for me are having people with the same level of commitment as I do. Even my level of commitment sometimes is not the best, because I have also other priorities like work and personal life to play a role. Also to have a club and a boat and other match racers next to you, I think it's definitely will help a lot, because sometimes it's not only of building a team, but building a community. And out of this community, there are way better chances that a team finds itself together. Then we come back to the team spirit and to having a right chemical set for the participants on the team. So yes, important is just to train and train and train. And if you can do it, if you have the boat available and have people and many people interested, that's very, very good potential for getting better and improving every time.
So the third question, the challenges you might face when trying to create a new team. I think the biggest challenge, as I said earlier, match racing takes up a lot of time. It's a lot of weekends, it's a lot of traveling, it's a lot of time away from often where you normally live. And it's very important that everyone you sail with can commit to doing a lot of sailing at the start of the season, because, as I said, it's very important that you trust your team, and the only way you end up trusting your team is if you sail with them a lot. So you got to make sure that everyone you sail with can commit to a schedule at the beginning of the season and sticks to it, and then, as I said, the results hopefully will follow and you won't have too many issues.
Yeah, so as Miles said, there's a lot of... the thing about commitment, about saying, okay, when do we practice? When do we, which events do we participate in? Can we all participate there? And how, and as I also experience it, is can we actually be a consistent crew on the way up to these races, so that you actually have because sometimes if you are missing just one crew member, the practice right before a race, the effect of training is actually maybe only 70% compared to if everybody's there. And then as Bernardo said, it's also important that you have a community. And I talked to him last time we raced against each other, that was sometimes an issue because they didn't always have the ability to get the boat at the same time and so on. So that was an extra challenge, at least compared to what we have in Skovshoved, north of Copenhagen. Mm. So, and how do you see that, Felix?
Sorry, Jan, but I need to have the question again.
Yeah, but how do you see that some of the challenges? How are in when you have been rats racing, what are the, you know, what has been the main challenges that you have experienced?
I think the main challenges I have experienced, I think that is the part of organization's stuff of sailing. When we are going out on sailing the different regattas, and who's taking care of the hotel where we are living, and who's there taking care of everything. I think the challenge is actually we've been answered for the last two questions. I think it's the same question but told different ways.
Yeah.
I think it's good enough for me. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. And I have tried to look a little bit into the theory. We have five or six small slides that we would like to talk about. And if we go to the first, you can see that if we look at theory, and basically it's both, you know, team building theory, but also about sailing. That is very much about having shared goals. We have already talked a little bit about that today. Clearly defined roles, and something about knowledge sharing and the skills that you actually all improve yourself all the time, and that's really important. And then of course the communication path, effective and timely, because often, you know, then there's a lot of wind, there's waves, and sometimes it's hard to tell the bowman something because he can't hear anything. And then of course, as we also have talked a little bit about today, is the thing about mutual respect and to have fun. And if we go to the shared goal part, then you can actually, you can choose to look at it in two ways. There's the you know, the very result oriented goals, like I want to be number one in the world or whatever. But you can also say, I want to sail Grade 5 events in my local club, and I will practice once a week, and I'll just going to have a lot of fun. And that is also a fine goal, especially if the whole crew align on this goal, then it's really good. And then of course you can go all the way and say, oh, I want to sail Grade 3 or Grade 2 or even Grade 1 events. But it's very important, because if you are not aligned on the goal, then you have a hard time being aligned on what it takes then to become a Grade 1 sailor or whatever. And then there's the whole thing about the ranking, that it needs, at least from my perspective, it needs to be a team effort. And we also talked a little bit about that, Felix.
Yeah, so the team effort, like, if all know, like in match racing ranking, world ranking, the match racing world ranking, there's only four regattas counting. So if you have a goal to become like, not putting too high goal for the year, but if you want to get into the number 100 on the world ranking, you're not participating like the highest regattas of the year. And it also takes a lot of money from your team, you're telling, okay, we are gonna sail four regattas this year, have to be Grade 4 or 5. We can go out maybe to Poland, we can go to England, but the most of the regattas are in Denmark. And of course, when you're doing a bad position, bad ranking on one regatta, then you might have to stay one more to getting better points for the ranking, overall ranking. Mm-hmm. The next rule is you can have, I think it's 8 regattas counting on your ranking for
2 years.
Yeah. So the second year you have, the first year is counting half, and then the next year is counting full. So when a regatta getting 1 year old, then it's counting half.
Yeah, exactly.
So half point.
Yeah. So and if you go back to the slide, we can see that, and that is kind of the and that is if you want as a team to go for a specific ranking as well. But I know that many crews are also say, we don't want to be good enough that we can participate in a grade two event, because then we can come to great places and sail in great boats and so on, so that you are good enough to be invited to some of these events. And then if you look at the people oriented goals, because some of the ones that comes to at least to Skovshoved in KDY is that, you know, they basically just they say, oh, we can actually become better sailors because match racing just makes you much better, because it's much more intensive than sailing a long stretch, because you have much more handling of the boat and so on. And then there's all these traveling experiences that is normally quite difficult to get. You need to have a boat, and you need to put it on a trailer and say and go somewhere. Here it's really easy. You just take your bag and then you go. So that is also a special thing about match racing, and maybe if that is more important for the crew, then talk about it within the crew to make sure that you are aligned on these things. So try to Yeah, and the whole point of this is actually that if you can make sure that the whole team is aligned on your goals, then you'll have a much better chance of having a success.
So we actually call that in Danish, we call that for taskesejler. That means a backpacker sailor.
Yeah.
So you are just packing your backpack and go to the flight and so the next will get her.
Yeah. if we take a little bit about the roles of the team, and if you look to the upper left, you see, you know, helmsman, trimmer, tactician, tailor, bowman, and so on. Those roles will come into that in another episode. But and then we also have, you know, other roles that, you know, who calls the wind, the puffs, ley lines, countdown of time, competitors, what are they doing, and so on. But actually some things that we do not often talk about, that is, okay, who's actually the expert of knowing exactly the notice of race? When is the you know, the morning meeting? Is there anything that where is there, you know, what about the press? How all these things that you actually read it and know everything about it, and some on board are better than others in a crew. So you have some kind of a notice of race expert. You have someone who is expert in fixing sail and gear and so on. You have people who are good at checking sailing instruction, flags, the rules, and also are we yellow or blue in the next race, or are we in first or second match? What should we put our times for? Is it 12 minutes? Is it 7 minutes? And so on. And I must admit that I have lost several matches simply because we didn't read the flags well enough. So that kind of gives some inspiration, or also some, you know, you really want to learn it, because after you have tried that a couple of times, then you don't want. And then the other thing is also, who's the travel agent on the team? Who's the sponsor manager? Who's the fitness? Who's the one that has total control of the calendar? But Felix, how have you, when you have sailed, have you also experienced that you know, these roles you know, makes a big difference in creating the good team?
Yeah, so I think when I stopped match racing as a helmsman, then you know, it was because I was organizing almost everything, and I getting super tired of that. Mm. Because you didn't, I was not thinking about everyone could have a job on board, as you know, who will find the hotel room, who will, I mean, the small thing, where we're gonna eat when we are finished racing. and so I think it's in the future, if you want to keep your team together, then you should especially find you know, different roles on board where you know, the team can find, organize everything together. And you know, Jan, if you was on my team, then I will tell you, okay, you will gonna handle the food.
Yeah.
Because I know you're good cooking. But you know, I think you know what I mean. If you're not doing it, you know, you can see what's going to happen. This is just my my stuff.
Yeah. Great. Let's take the next slide. That is more about, you know, how do we actually share the knowledge and improve our skills. I mean, of course, something that is important is that all crew members you know, watch, they watch, you know, YouTube clips. They try to read about sailing trim, discuss the match racing rules. It's extremely complicated, and it is very important that the whole crew understands these things. And it's also about, you know, talking about it after, when we have done a practice or whatever, and also use the tactics boards. And one of the good things that we have done with the help from Felix is having onboard video to discuss situation, and especially boat handling, and we're going to talk about that in a different episode as well. So and also, you know, the thing about learning from your mistakes and so on. So that's really, and actually you have done a lot of video, how are your experiences using video on practicing?
Yeah, so I think I'm using GoPro, and you can putting all your data of sailing, how did you perform on the water, you can put that everything on the Excel, and then you can see, okay, in this tag you actually, if you are going down on the leeward side too early, we actually lose so much. So you know, if you can putting a camera up, you can also use it for boat handling. Okay, so when should I ease the jib sheet, and when should I, you know, go walking over to the other side after the tack? How do we move on the boat?
Yeah.
So I'm using a video a lot, especially when we're going out sailing a bigger boat than just not only match racing.
Yeah.
Also get busted when you do something wrong, and that is another thing.
Yeah. Very good. Let's go to the next slide, because we also have this thing about communication. And actually, on our boat, we have one from Iran, one from Italy, and three from Denmark.
And you're all in from Widex?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, we are. And the big challenge there is that you know, we all speak English on board, but actually. What is bang? I sometimes, you know, then you have different words where what do you actually mean when you say different commands, and if you are, I mean, and none of us are native English speakers, so sometimes we actually have a little bit of a problem talking to each other about what do we actually mean with different, so, and people have to think a lot, so that is something that we can really improve. And actually what also sometimes happens is that then maybe two of the Danish, they start speaking Danish, and then the Italian guy doesn't speak Danish at all, so then he understands nothing, so it's really about trying to keep it in English all the time, so that's just maybe special for our crew, but we also need to talk about, you know, the meaning of different terms. For example, you know, if someone is looking at the competitor and saying, okay, faster, that means we are faster than them and not that the competitor is faster. But actually, you need to have decided how does it actually mean? And we are constantly trying to do that, but we are definitely not 100% good at that yet, that's for sure.
Yeah, I think it's everything comes when you go out training, and you know, then you're also getting new words on the boat. So in Denmark, we have a word called idiot, and that means when the halyard going on the wrong side of the mast. And if you're going out, that is a type of Danish humor, because we also have something they call a kiwi drop, because we one time saw a kiwi guy in Team New Zealand. They're making going high wind and downwind, going down, and then they make the drop at the same time they're rounding the mark.
Yeah, so a really cool spinning.
A really rounding. Cool, yeah. And we saw a New Zealander do that, and then we call that a kiwi drop, of course. Mm. And then almost all the team in Denmark, and now also international, they call that for a kiwi drop.
Yeah.
But easy with the idiot, because if you're going out and telling idiot to an international team, they don't know what it is, and they are only thinking you think they are an idiot.
Yeah. When I started sailing, the helmsman was shouting idiot, and I was always thinking, I know it's a term, he's not actually saying it to me, but yeah. I still feel a little bit offended in the first second or two until I kind of realize it is a term, so we kind of changed that. But let's go to the next
the last one.
Then the last slide here, and that is more actually that's more general, because in all team building and so on, you need to give feedback in a constructive way, and sometimes that can be really really hard, because also on board you need to be very precise, and sometimes even and you also need to sometimes the crew needs to shout, because you cannot hear if there's a lot of wind, so. But that is one thing, but it's also about mutual respect is that, for example, when you are practicing, tell that oh, I can't come next Wednesday for practice or whatever, because it's really something that you're very dependent on each other, because you're only five. It's not like you have a big football team where maybe you are 14 and you only need, let's say, 11 or 12 on the pitch. But here, actually, if one is missing, then the effect of the practice is just 70% or something. So it's really important that it's the right people and that they are there for the training. But of course, we also have to remember that most of us are not pros. It's only guys like you, Felix. And then the whole thing about having fun, we need to remember that. And I guess we also do. But it's especially if you go to races elsewhere, and also just races in your own club, because you have there's quite often a bit of waiting time, and there you have a good chance of talking about all other kinds of things than sailing and so on. So that's, I also think that's important.
I think like the best thing I can come up with, like, have something else when you're out on the regattas, so do something else and not sailing. So it's a normal work day, as go out sailing, it's your office, you're going out sailing, that's it. And then you can do something else and not sailing after sailing.
Yeah.
So I remember we always book us in on a nice hotel when they have a good spa, and we also find some nice what do you call that, go-karting.
Yeah.
Splatter guns, yeah. And then you can really hit your driver if you anchor at him. So I think to do something else and not sailing, and do some team building. I'm almost running every time before sailing all morning. I've been so I can think something else, and then you also focus more on sailing when you are in infight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was actually what we have chosen to show for you today. That was a little bit about how to create and how to keep a good match racing team. And next time we are going to talk about
the next steps to create a good match racing team.
Yeah, and actually what we really would. In the next episode of this Widex Matchrace Academy, we will talk about sail trimming, and hopefully we will have some really really clever people to help so we look forward to that. But thank you for joining this first episode of the Widex Matchrace Academy, and we wish you a great evening, and hope to see you on the water soon.
Stay safe.
Yeah, stay safe.